Okay, this is straight out of the box. I haven't touched any controls on this radio. This is what I see when I look at a radio brand new off of it. We're going to go up, we're going back, and we'll see what we got on dead key. 4.2 watts. Alright, let's see what we've got. The mic gain is all the way up. This is fully stocked. Hello audio, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 23.07 watts, dead bone stock right out. We haven't turned the mic modulation up in the radio, we've done nothing. I'll show you the scope pattern. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's with talking. I'll show you on a tone. And there you can see there's a tone. Okay, give me just a minute. We're going to do a quick tune and we'll come back and we'll see what the numbers are and we'll take a look at the scope again. Okay, we're back. What we've done here is we've went through, just did a standard tune. So let's take a look at our dead key, see if it's changed any. We got 5.87. Let's take a look at our wattage. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 30.8 watts with just me talking. So it came up to normal Cobra. You know, that's just about right. Let's look at our pattern. Now this is with the mic gain all the way up. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test, we'll look at it with a tone, and yes, it is over 100% and it's starting to top a little, but that's basically the way things are. The modulation limiter has not been cut, I just turned it up in the radio, and we'll show you that. Now, just a second, we'll show you with the limiter disabled completely. I'll be right. Okay, we've got the limiter cut, which is, I think pretty well everyone knows that's D11 or some form of that. Let's see if we've got any difference in our wattage. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 29.2 watts, if you'll notice. Now let's go over and look at our scope pattern. As we talk. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On a tone, a little difference, not a lot of difference between, if you'll notice, between the actual pattern that we have with the limiter completely disabled versus being turned up. As a matter of fact, our wattage actually went down just a little bit by clipping the limiter. Alright, so we've got through that. Let's go to the receive side. We'll see what, matter of fact, let's just see how close it is on frequency as it stands. Turn the mic gain off. So we come out of the box at 2720524, which is not perfect. It's acceptable for AM. I always like to bring those things a little closer than that. So give me just a second. We're going to do that, and then we'll look at the receipt. Okay, we're back. 2720499, almost right on the money to 5. Matter of fact, that is perfect right there. I like it. I like to send them out like that, even though it doesn't really matter. Just makes me feel a little better to know it's right on the money. Okay, let's get with the receive. I'm going to set up the signal generator and we'll be right back. Okay, we're back. We've got the signal generator on channel 20. We're running 30 microvolts input with a 30% modulated AM signal. And looking at the digital meter on the front, we're showing about a 7, which it should be up to at least a 9 or so. So let's run this real quick and see if we can make any improvements. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. And yes, it did come up a little bit as normal for a Cobra. They're never quite right on frequency. We're up to a solid 9, flashing just a hair higher. Now, I did not go through this thing step by step. as Emmanuel would say. I just did a down dirty alignment, more of a CB shop along the road that doesn't have the time to align one type of deal, but you can get an improvement out of it if somebody runs the alignment. So there you have it, folks. We're not going to go much farther with this today. I've shown you the basic features of the radio, the colors. I've shown you the wattage out of the box, wattage with a standard peak and tune. We've disabled the modulation limiter, which I don't do, by the way, but I've shown you the difference between it disabled and with it just turned up from the pot. We've shown you scope pattern. We've shown you receive. We've shown you frequency. So we went through the basics of this radio. I hope this has helped. It's not as glamorous as the RFX is, but just gives you an idea of what you've got with the basic unit. If you guys need any of these radios, I do have them. See me at my website, which is customcbradios.com. This is CB Repairman saying so long until the next video.